Hi, Jonathan York from Bay Financial Partners, looking at investment markets. Interesting situation appears to be developing at the Fed now, with a little bit of dissension in the ranks, and a little bit more talk coming through about a potential of a rate hike now in the US. Now, while it's only a couple of sort of lone voices out there at the moment, certainly with the U.S. economy and the data coming through, especially on the employment side, that unemployment rate below 5%, for most people that's pretty much full employment, and you're starting to see a little bit of pickup now in the hourly earnings as well, which sort of stokes a little bit of inflationary pressures coming through. And certainly the U.S. economy has grown really well over the last sort of couple of years, and what it would do is just give the Fed a little bit of ammunition. Sort of going forward, if they could just get rates a little bit higher. And not saying they should be raising rates just so they can cut them later, in case the situation worsens. But certainly, with the artificially low rates at present, that certainly has been, the case for obviously quite a while now. The US does need to get back to a more sort of neutral footing. Now, obviously, that's not going to be as high as in previous cycles, but certainly at current levels, interest rates do need to be higher. So what does that do? Does that put the September meeting as a live meeting now, a potential for a rate increase? I don't think so, but certainly November, December certainly come into play, and you would expect a rate increase at one of those meetings. It's really quite interesting if you look at markets at sort of present. Traditionally you've had bonds that have been the sort of income driver, and equities have been there for sort of capital pickup. Really what you're seeing is a sort of reverse of that relationship now, where bonds are obviously providing a very low income but providing some very good capital pickup, and equities out there are providing a pretty decent income stream in terms of dividends. It's obviously particularly the case here in New Zealand, with the equity market, providing a pretty decent dividend yield going forward. Bonds are really sort of, they're not struggling, but in terms of income going forward, maybe sort of 3 or 4 years ago you were getting 7-8%. Nowadays you're getting sort of 4 or below. That obviously makes a pretty major impact on the income stream going forward for investors. As discussed here many times, there are plenty of options out there to consider. And if you're interested in looking at these options, call us on 0800 867 323 or go to the website www.bayfinancialpartners.co.nz. Oil starting to edge up a little bit as well. It's sort of in those high 40s now. It's just going to be interesting to see as we sort of head into the northern hemisphere winter, just to see what happens to those oil prices. Certainly the southern hemisphere winter has been pretty mild, and if that's the case for the north as well, then oil may not be under quite as much pressure. So, say looking for income options here in New Zealand, call us on 0800 867 323 or go to the website www.bayfinancialpartners.co.nz for lots of interesting articles. I look forward to speaking to you soon.